Yes.
I'll tell mine. I have some where we, at don't do a transaction that month, you don't get a check. I work straight commission, so I don't work, I'm home. So you have those times where you're like, okay, thank God for the credit card. You know what I mean? Like, at least go and charge the groceries for this month and then get back out there and hustle for the next month.
So there was a time that I was there too. That was probably the main one for me, because I don't do good.
I'm anxiety driven. I know, Jesus help me. Anyway, I don't like having that feeling at all, at all. I will eat beans and rice, and I don't like rice. So for me not to be in that place, that means for me I have to go back in to get into a mental standpoint. No, I can't go out this week. No, I can't go friends or go traveling or, you know, whatever it is the case. You have to put yourself in that place where this is really, really important to get you out of there. It alters so many parts of who you are. And remember, we talked about last week, the cognitive thinking, what we do, how we respond, what we act. It alters all that in our daily, daily lives. So it's real important that you make it a priority to change whatever you need to change so that we can get out of these predicaments. Which ways do you think would be good ways of getting out of this?
There's some things going like cable.
I don't have cable.
And eating out all the time.
Yeah, I do like to do that. That's not going nowhere. That's a good one. That's a relaxing time for me. I'll go by myself. Right, no vacations. That's a good one. No shopping.
Yeah, I work shopping.
Yep, that's it. Nails, hair, hands, eyelashes. Yep. She said that's true. Some of those, I know I went to a coffee place and that's a good $820. So if you want some nice ones, you want some real hair and stuff, lashes are not cheap. So I mean, those are easy things. If you go back to your late payments on your bills, what's ways you can break those down too? Same thing.
Pay them on
time.
And department. And I don't know anybody who have department store credit cards now. I mean, because the interest rate on those is just crazy.
There's tons of them. Yeah. Some of those you can get approved quicker for than you can a credit card.
But if you're going to use those, you should just pay those off at the end of the month.
Right, you should. You should have to pay them right when you get the statement in the mail. But they know. Like, you really was broke. But back then, you know, as a kid growing up, that was huge.
Yeah.
You know, to see it. So that's what piqued our interest. And she took the time to invest in us, you know, to nurture that. So that's where it came from me. But it was true. I was determined not to be there. But you have to have that mindset. My friends will tell you, I will say no to them. No, I can't go. I mean, I don't really like to hang with too many people anyway. So I'm like, no, I'm good. I go home, you know, mama's gonna cook something for sure. So I'll eat there and save my dough. Always get it. So it's an initiative that you have to take so that you don't fall into these other situations too, because it does. It changes and alters who you are as far as your credit life and how your credit repair works. And I know this is kind of similar off the topic. It's not off the topic. It's very particularly to what we're talking about when you're looking at repairing and building your credit. As you look at the things, it gets overwhelming to look at your credit report. So you get a little like, I'll deal with this tomorrow. you know, kind of thing. And then tomorrow turns into next week, and next week turns into next year. Right. So it never, ever gets done. So you have to keep it at the forefront of your mind. Remember what your goal is in doing it. So I say that to say, let's look at our credit reports. So, if you have your credit report, you can pull it out. If you don't, we are going to make available to you this evening. If you want us to scan it in, my sister brought the scanner in, so we will scan it through and I will look at it just to kind of help you all as far as what direction you might want to go with yours. If you have, I'm not doing a credit repair. Please hear me. I'm not tackling doing everyone's credit repair, but I do want to at least invest into each one that wants the service where I'll look at them and kind of give you a direction as to which way you can go with your credit repair and fixing it. It's seriously something you can do, and I don't mind helping you. We're not going to get it done in 8 weeks. There's no way possible that we can get it all done in the 8 weeks, but we can start. I want us to at least be able to get our first draft letter out to challenge things that may need to be challenged on it, or at least start getting things corrected on it. If you have address changes that need to be done, let's get those done. Those are easy things that we can quick send letters out and get those quick. It usually takes them 30 to 45 days to respond. By law, they have 30 days to respond. So we want them to give us that time. That'll give us right to the end of August if we get those out this week, which is our goal. We want to get them out this week. Did
want to
mention, once we send, yes, sir.
Could you go back, and I don't know, Brother Knight, I was upstairs real quick trying to get to you. But could you just go back over the reason why we don't do it electronically? I don't know if you talked about that.
Oh, no, sir, I didn't. We don't want to send them electronically. So everything we do, we want it to be by snail mail. And the reason you do that, once you're on the website, if you go to TransUnion's website, theirs is usually the easiest one to read through the small print on. If you go down, after you fill out the stuff on TransUnion, and they have a very beautiful website that just draws you in, and you're like, yes, this is going to be so much easier, because they tell you you can get it done in 2 to 3 days, which you can, and it will take them 2 to 3 days to get it. But then you read on down, you waive all your rights to further disputes through them. If you send it through the website again, all your rights to any disputes that you send in, you completely waive it. So we don't want to waive our rights. We don't want them to challenge you back on that, which there are cases, and you can look on their websites too, or go to your local attorney general office and see cases where they have challenged those. So we don't want to even face it to get it. Yet again, you can get it done in 30 days, but when you do it, you do take the other risks that come along. That's why we don't want to do it electronically. If you want to do it electronically, by all means, do it. So we're going to start looking at our credit report. The purple one says credit repair at the top. So you know, federally, credit repair is governed by the Federal Trade Commission as far as the overall concept of credit repair. So you can go to the Federal Trade Commission's website and you can get all these documents. They are free. They are free to consumers completely. They only let you order 10 at a time, so you've just been lucky to order a bunch of them. But if you go to page 3, and there, it does talk a little bit about doing it step by step, which we're not going to read through the whole thing. I just want to let you all see where everything is at so that you can go back and check. See why I say what I say when I say it. I'd rather you be knowledgeable too, not just taking my word for it. Isn't that how the preacher say? You need to read the Bible yourself. So I want you to be knowledgeable too, and not just take my word for it whenever we say anything. But it does tell you the concept behind doing it yourself. Only thing you're doing is challenging what is on your credit report. If it's wrong, you're letting them and making them aware that it is wrong, and that you know what your right is as a consumer to have that removed or corrected. It's your choice as to which one you want done to it, depending on the letter that you're sending. So if you tell them you want your address corrected, it should just be correcting your address, not your address, your name, phone number, everything else. So it's just going to depend on how you say it, whatever you say. So when you look at your credit report, that first section on page one of your credit report should be, and you can tell me if yours is different. Did everyone get theirs off of Privacy Guard or annualcreditreport.com? So all those places, okay. So it should all be the same. So your first section on there is going to be your name, address, and phone number. You should have three columns, one for Experian, TransUnion, and then Equifax. So you'll have your name and phone number, name, address, and date of birth should be in those sections. You want to make sure that those are all correct. I say use just the most current address that you have that you want to keep on there. It's going to be on your actual, you got that one? Yeah, okay. Use your most current address that you have for your credit report. You can change them. I do have two addresses on mine just because I do use two different addresses for when I report personal credit, so it just depends on what it's for. So if your addresses on yours are correct, then you want to keep them there. If they're incorrect, we want to challenge it. So I would encourage you to just either circle it if it's wrong or if it's something that you want to change. Or on those three sheets that we have that we used to last week that our assignments were, you can write on one of them, whichever one it is that you know it needs to be changed. Somewhere on the back of it or on the front of it, you can write challenge address. And that's for whichever one it is, Experian, Equifax, or TransUnion. Did everyone understand that? Okay, good. Yes, sir?
So I have quite a few
Yeah, I think we talked about it. Yours is probably going to want to challenge.
Oh, sweet.
Sisters, scan yours for sure. Okay. So yeah, you can. I would challenge them. I would. Don't want to keep extra ones, old ones on there. If you have like old bills or anything like that, that people are trying to find you, that's the first way that they'll know that they have the right person. So you want to challenge and get everything old and moved off. Again, our process. Remember, we're doing this for home ownership. So we're doing things that the mortgage lender is going to need to see when they go to look at your credit files. They don't want to see 20 different addresses. That's just another red flag to them. Maybe your mother can talk to them or it'd be tough to think, you never know what they think. I will give you all those resources that you can use.
If you want to pay for those services, those are not services that are offered, so they are third-party service providers. So I'll let you know of those if that's something that you're interested in doing. But right now, I really just want you all to focus on doing it yourself. It's not hard. I promise you it's not hard. You don't have to write them down. I'm going to send you the sample letters. All you have to do is literally cut and paste, cut and paste, cut and paste. There's some people that actually do that all day long. I do use a system for it just because I use it for my clients a lot. It's an easy way for me to boost my clientele so that I am able to be out instead of that's why I use it. So when you go to the next section on there, most of them it should show, start showing your history on your reports. Mostly everybody show history next. Yeah. So it's going to start showing your history on your credit report. In that section there, you want to write down anything in there that just looks wrong. I mean, if it doesn't even look right, if the balances don't look right, if you have judgments, which there was a new law that came out on July 1st in reference to judgments, a lot of judgments should be coming off your credit report this month. This month here, they should be coming off. The law changed that they can no longer report them if they don't have all the correct information. So it's just yet one more thing that we get to challenge and take off. So it is in the consumer's favor that those get to come off on your credit reports. And that's the new law that just went into effect July 1st. So they should start coming off. We'll get an email. I think I have the alert back there on the back page. It just sent out July 1st, 2017 for the rumors. And the Department of Education should be taking some off too. The TransUnion, that is not for all of them. The TransUnion has announced it. And you know, most of these laws, if you never ever, if you don't know how it starts, most everything starts with TransUnion. And then the other two follow suit. Because some wise person sues the other two after TransUnion gets sued. So everyone thinks Equifax is the bigger, better one, but TransUnion is pretty much the bigger one. So those will be starting effective July 1st. Once I hear more on those, and most of them are derogatory, but it looks like it is more than 26 million credit files that have been affected. So I'm sure some of us may be in the number, so that'll be good. So back to the credit files. On that second section, you'll have your history, any charge-offs, judgments, anything like that. You want to, again, put them on your list to write those down so that we can have those once we send out our letters on there. Then the next section is going to actually start with your credit report. That's the juice of it. And in those sections, that's where you want to write out on your sheet which company is in those sections. So if you're looking at an Experian file, it's reporting to all three of them, you want that client, that account, and your start date to be on each one of those sheets. It's a tedious task, I know, but I'm telling you, it would help you so, so much once you get to the point where you're ready to send out your letter, because you'll know which one's the challenge for one. Remember, we don't want to challenge everything that's on the credit report, because we will not be doing ourselves justice if we take our time out. If you're 50 years old and you challenge everything on your account, and you take your account down to 5 years old, they're going to know something is wrong. Like, this is not a five-year-old person, or they haven't, you know, they're just not over 5 years with credit file. So they'll know stuff, which will cause them to dig even deeper. They ask you for more documents. They're going to send you to get more tax documents. So we don't want to take our complete file away. And we don't want to take things that are no longer affecting our scores. So just because you have an old account on your credit file doesn't mean that is affecting your score. Remember we talked about inquiries last week? You can have Google's inquiries, but as long as they're not 8 months or older, 7 months or older, they're not affecting your score. So anything that's 7 months or younger actually calculates into your score, which is what you need. If you have CreditWise through Capital One, or if you have a Capital One credit card, they offer CreditWise to you at no charge. And you can go on there. It's an awesome one. You can go on there and it will actually tell you
which accounts are affected. So you'll say you have 5 inquiries. And you're like, no, I have 60 inquiries. No, you have 5 that are really counting towards your score. So it'll actually give you the number of them, and it's going to be your latest one. So from the date that you look at it, going back to 5 will be the ones that are actually affecting your score. So you don't have to worry about those other two. They fall off every 2 years anyway. I don't ever challenge inquiries, never. Never ever challenge it, because 9 times out of 10, you ask the people to look at your credit. When you do it, and again, I'm not doing nothing illegal, or you're not coming to pick me up or coming to pick up nothing I own because I challenged someone's inquiry. And I saw him just now. Oh, sorry. Shows up on your credit report that you can physically see if you pull it through like Privacy Guard or any of those places. If you go through and get it from Experian, Equifax, or TransUnion, they're going to have all your inquiries on it, but it should label it as a soft inquiry or one that you're just able to see. So you, as the owner of the credit file, you'll be able to see any soft inquiries. If you're pulling it up as like Privacy Guard, any other credit monitoring services, then you won't see any of your soft inquiries. There's a couple credit card companies, and I did bring a secure card brochure. They do only soft card inquiries. You have them already on your desk. Yeah, those credit card companies, they do soft inquiries only. I was going to make mention of them, and I know our time goes by so fast. They're a company for credit building credit. And I wanted to go ahead and give those out. If you need a credit card on your account, you research the company. Do not take my word for it. Go research them. But that's a good company. It's $200 for a secure card. That just gives you one more additional line that you can have. Remember, we don't just want to repair our credit. We want to build it also, so that we're able to build our scores up, so that we're able to purchase a home in the range that we want to. We want to get our best interest rates and put our best foot forward when we do go to purchase a home. So that's one card. Capital One has a secured card that's really good. And they charge either $49, $99, or $200, and you get a $200 line with theirs to build your credit. Secured cards, 9 times out of 10, for either one of those companies, you're going to be approved. unless your credit is really, really bad. But 9 times out of 10, you'll get approved for secured cards, and that'll allow you to build your credit. Remember, we only want to do 7%. That's what I say. Nationally, they tell you to be 30%. We only want 30% utilization on your card. Your utilization is how much of our credit score? 30%, yep. So it's a big, big part of your credit score. So you want to make sure that we're utilizing all of our accounts properly. If you have a line of credit, same thing. You don't want to charge it up too much on this, ma'am.
I'd like to know, what do you think is a healthy amount of trade
on? I think it's different for different people. Depending on what you're using it for, what are you having it for? If you're just having a trade line just to build a credit up, or you're including like JCPenney's and Macy's and all those trade lines too, or just loans from credit unions, would you include in your trade line?
Well, kind of just to get a whole mix, if you're building your score higher.
I would say two trade lines, 3 credit cards on there. That's the only time I would ever tell anybody to do credit cards. That's the only reason I have them. And I promise you, they have a $1 balance. I do Netflix on one, and the other one, I think I did ice cream cone from QT for my niece, and I pay it off when the statement comes in, 79 cents. The lower your utilization, the higher your score goes. And if you just want to keep your scores, you know, higher for that, but don't use them at all. Use it once a month. I'm so serious about once a month to use it. If you cannot trust yourself to use them, don't keep them. And that's serious. Find a different way. See, if you can't trust yourself not to use credit cards or not to charge up stuff, I don't use credit cards. I've really do not use credit cards. I kill my debit card, but I do not use credit cards. That's just because of me. I would probably get excited or get depressed one day and just go tear Macy's up. So I don't use them. And I know as long as I can have my checkbook balance where I can balance my checkbook, I know for sure it's not going to go below something. So, all right, then we take it to the house. We figure out, read a book, eat some candy or something. You know, some other item. You just have to know yourself. So if you know you're not good with credit cards, don't use them. Don't take my word for it or anyone else's. Do not use them. Find some other way. But having at least three of them will increase your credit score. So if you get them for a certain amount of time, you know, even when my sister had them, she would give them to me to keep. And she's like, no, I'm not keeping those cards. So I would throw them in the safe or something. I mean, figure out a way. Give them to someone you trust. Something else, but it does, I mean, will increase your score fast. One secure credit card can get you 35 points in 30 days. I mean, that's real easy. You pay it off, and that increases you another 12 to 20 points just from making that payment on it. And you don't want to pay it completely off. So if your balance is, you know, within that 7%, just pay what the statement says. So if you pay it off every month, they're like, oh, they're not using that card. So you want to use it, but your utilization has to hit when your credit card cycles around. So that would be the only spill that you all get from me ever on credit cards, seriously, is just to increase your scores. I think on the last part of the credit report, once you go through all of your accounts on there, your last part is going to be your, did we take collections? Did we get collections section right underneath the history part. It's going to be where your collections or judgments or anything like that. And then you'll go into your accounts. So that's going to be the end of your whole complete credit file. I'm not going to call anything out on there. If you have anything particular on your credit file that you definitely want me to take a look at, again, my sister's back there. She'll scan it in and I'll be more than happy to take a look at it with you. I think I spoke to a few people this week past for their credit file. Yes, sir?
So once you credit file.
No, don't close them. Don't close them at all. Especially if you're doing it for home ownership, you don't want to close them out. If your old ones are there, that will reduce your points. That will reduce your points. And let me say this, too. As far as credit card scores going up, or excuse me, credit report scores going up, if you don't pay your bill on time, or if you make a late payment on there, and your score goes down, I don't want to hear it. I really don't. Because your main focus is to pay your bills on time. So we are working towards that. So if you don't pay it on time, guess what happens? It goes down. It really goes down. The email to me saying, oh my God, my score just went down 38 points. Yes, it's because that Macy's charge was due on the 12th and you paid it on the 28th. If it gets paid on the 13th, it's going down. They're not going to be happy with you. You might be able to write a goodwill letter if it's the first time, and get them to correct it once. It may just be nice and change it. But if not, after that, it's not going to change at all. So we have to pay our bills on time. Yes, ma'am?
What about, say, for instance, like, oh, your auto payment, it may be due on the 15th, but as long as you pay it within those 30 days, they don't report it to the credit agency. If you pay it within those 30 days, is that still a hit?
It can be. It depends on the credit, the company itself. So it depends on how they report theirs. I would stress, try not to. Even if you have to double up on the payment to get it one ahead, if you have that type of loan. Some loans don't let you pay your car payments ahead of time. But if you have that type of loan where you can pay it ahead, I would double up on it. If you know that sometimes you do lag behind, or like if you get paid on the 1st and the 15th and your payment is due on the 15th, it may be a little harder, you know, to pay it right on that date. But if you can pay it on that date, pay it on that date.
Mm-hmm. Now, say, for instance, like with an auto loan, if you paid it twice, if you broke it up, would that help boost your credit score?
It does, yeah, two times. That's the other thing. Thank you, that's a good point. That's the other thing with those cards, that sheet that I gave you, they report six times per month to the credit bureau. So if nothing else, that helps you boost your scores quicker. The more more often they do report, the higher your points will go. As long as everything in totality is, you know, done good. I don't want to say just because you pay your car payment, because I know I'll get an email. I don't want to say that. Just because you pay your car payment, that all your scores are going to go up. No. Everything, all your accounts have to be paid on time. All your credit cards have to be within the utilization time frame. So it's a work in progress. So it's going to take time. So we just have to, like, eat the meat, spit out the bones as far as, okay, right now I'm not there. So we know that we want to get to that point. So what we need to start doing now is preparing ourselves to cut out all of these little fun things here so that we don't get backed up on ours and we're able to, you know, get back on a regular regimen to pay our bills on time and to make our scores increase. Are we good? Mm-hmm. Any other questions, guys?
You may have answered this question, but I wasn't here on the first session.
That's fine.
But what's a realistic view to look at and say, I can rebuild my credit score? Is it 6 months to a year? What's realistic?
It depends on your credit file, what you have on there. If you're just general with collections, charge-offs, credit card late pays, car payment, or something like that, then I would say 6 to 12 months. Again, it is going to depend on how eager you are to get it done. If you turn in your letters on time, if you mail them off, remember it takes 30 days for the bureaus to respond back to you. 9 times out of 10, we're doing it by snail mail, so we're not going online doing them to get the quick response. So it does take about 30 days for those letters to come back from them. And then once you receive those back, you have to respond back to them. So either you're doing it through the collection agency, if you have to respond directly to the collection agency. And they will respond. It's going to take time. They will respond. You have to respond back to them. Or if you do use a credit repair company, you have to get all the documents over to them so that they're able to at least mail off the letters to find out or decide on how much you're going to pay. If you're negotiating collections, I never say pay off collections without them giving you a pay for delete. So you want it off your credit report for sure. So negotiate with them. You have to send them a letter, tell them how much you owe to pay. Maybe they'll accept it, maybe they won't. So they'll send you a letter back. So it can be back and forth for a couple of months, and in that time you're just in lingo waiting. So 6 to 12 months, depending on what you have on there. I've seen them 18 to 2 years. I still have people that are fixing their credit. I mean, it took you a long time to get them there. So it didn't take you, you know, 6 to 8 months to get it in the predicament that you're in now. So it's going to take time to, you know, get it back out on this. That's why I say don't make it rush. I mean, you might have your two-year goal is to be in a house by the end of the year. It's realistic. It just depends on how much you're willing to work for it and do it on there. That's for all of us. Me too. Any other questions?
I have a question.
Yeah.
So if there's something on there that you have maybe 2 years or something to pay off, and you're like, well, no, a year.
Mm-hmm.
And you have a place to pay it off, is it safe to say you can just let it go, or because it's going to fall off the next year?
Mm-hmm.
Not safe to say yes, ma'am.
Okay. I would.
I just heard something earlier. Somebody was on a radio show, and they paid a debt that was about to fall off in a couple of months. And so they found out after they did it. So that's why I asked if that just made sense. If they're, you know, if it's not affecting anything, because it was old.
Yeah, if it's an old account, and you're close to your statute of limitation dates on it, I would let it sit right there and ride it. Ride it right till it falls off. And if it doesn't fall off on the date, I had an inquiry that was supposed to fall off on the 18th, I think it was June, January, something like that. And I looked on the 18th, and it was still there. I'm sending a letter. Y'all need to get this off. I mean, once they know you know the law, they usually don't have any pushback or anything like that to them. And some of those things, yeah, send a letter. I was going to say, some of those things you can call in. If it's your personal credit file, I mean, you can call in to some of the places, but I don't want to contradict what I said. So we are mailing out everything. We're not calling anybody, only because you want to get a record that they said they're going to do what they said they're going to do. Mm-hmm. And it's 9 times usually with collection agencies that you want that record. Because they will, you will get Joe this time, Susan tomorrow, Jane next week, and it'll be 10 different people that you talk to, and every single one of them will have a different story or a different time frame.
Yes, ma'am. My question is, so when you send out
emails today, but I could not get the email, the Word document, because I put them all in Word, so you're able to go and copy and paste right into the letters. So I'll just email it the regular way. So we'll email those out to you in the morning.
So my question is, you continue to pay for them. Mm-hmm. It's my understanding when you're saying that, that you're sending these to our creditors, mainly collection
collections.
When, let's say, pay to delete it, once we pay it, they're going to delete it off our credit report, or?
Once they agree to delete it off the credit report, then we're going to pay it.
So it's going to just physically disappear?
Well, I don't know how it's going to disappear and or if it's going to disappear, but I'm going to have a letter. So if they don't take it off, then I'm going to get it taken off. I send it to the collection, to the credit bureaus.
Gotcha.
Yeah. So you'll send the paper. And that works. For me, that was wonderful. Paper deletes. I'll pay it. I'm not saying I don't owe it. That was not what I said. It's a bill I created. I want to pay it. But if I pay it, we can delete it off my credit, because they are not obligated by law to delete that off your credit report. It can sit there for the whole 7 years. But it's a collection account, so you can either take my letter or you can send it. Right. So you have, they have an option too. Most of the time, it's been sold to another company that care less about the first company. So they'll usually pay it, delete it off. Yes, sir?
In 4 years for Georgia, 4 years for credit cards, anything?
Okay.
I have credit cards that were started 4 years ago, past 4 years ago. I can have those.
4 years for credit card, yes. Do you have some that are older than 4 years that are showing on your? You have some that are older than 4 years. Yours will be pretty easy, because you can just send a letter and they're going to remove them. And 6 years for any written contracts, which would be the open ended line of credits or stuff like that, for a state of Georgia. And that's the state that it originated, that the debt originated.
And that's supposed to be considered under the other statute of limitations?
Written contracts. Okay. It's going to be your rentals, which is 6 years for Georgia. And that's good, because Georgia only has two, so it's either 4 years for cards and oral, or 6 years for mortgages for open-ended written contracts.
Let me ask you about that kind of question, because actually the girl there, I'm questioning, why was in Alabama? And it paid off. I can go back in
6 years for Alabama.
And what about Florida?
Florida has 5 years for line of credits, 4 years for oral and credit cards.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
I
emailed it out. Everyone should have got this on their email Monday.
What is it for Ohio?
Ohio is, oh yeah, Ohio is a lovely state. 15 years for Ohio for written, and then 6 years for credit cards. Yeah. So we don't want to get anything in Ohio, Kentucky, Illinois, or Indiana. Don't open no accounts in any of those places.
What about New Mexico?
Huh?
What about? Oh.
You never see, did anybody else get this on their email? Me, KimberlyLeeds@gmail.com. Did anyone get the video?
Yes.
Yeah. You should be attached to that same
email. Junk mail.
Yeah, I sent it twice because everybody was calling me saying, I didn't mean that.
Uh-huh.
I have a question about page 3 in the paragraph. It talks about credit reporting companies must investigate items in question within 30 days unless they consider your dispute frivolous.
Frivolous,
uh-huh. That's all subjective. I think, how can they just consider it frivolous?
That's one of their tactics. It's called a stall tactic. So if they think you are just sending it in to aggravate them, or they think you're just sending it in, and people do it. They have a case with Equifax that a guy goes into Equifax every single day, 6 months straight. A law that you can walk into Equifax and request that they give you your credit report every day for 6 months. It's free. Yes, if you walk inside the building. But as you know, against y'all being here, they don't want you really coming in. They're building at the Equifax Center. They really try to avoid any walk-in traffic there. he will go there every day. It's a big, I mean, you can look it up online. It's a big story where he went in every day. So they flagged his account frivolous, where he's just coming in to aggravate us, pretty much. So if they think you're aggravating them or anything like that, they got it in the law that they can flag your account frivolous. It doesn't happen as much unless someone just constantly, because, again, by law, you can dispute your transactions as many times as you want to, but you will get flagged frivolous. If you keep saying, this is not my account, or and they send you a letter proving that it is your account, and you say, no, I didn't sign it on this date. So they research and see you did sign it on this date, or you call them back and say, it wasn't for this amount. They research it. You know, once you keep doing that, they're going to be like, okay, yeah, they're playing with us. They know this is their deal, and they flag you as frivolous. Oh, no, you're good.
I was so pleased.
I have a question because, you know, that one collection that I didn't have, which was the medical bill.
Yes, ma'am.
On the Equifax, when I originally did it before you gave us the level trust, now it shows on our level that the date of first delinquency was 3 of 2013.
Mm-hmm.
But when I went in and pulled the three credit bureaus off of the website that you gave us, you know, another cop that has picked it up now, right?
Okay.
So it shows that the date open was 6/16 or 2016, which is incorrect.
Right. So we would send a letter for that, and that would be an easy one.
Okay.
We'll send a letter for that and get that taken off. If there's anything, I mean, any discrepancies on them, it's honestly a pretty much sure thing to get them taken off. They are not, which we didn't even open the law stuff. The law packet that I gave you is actually the law section of the Fair Credit Reporting Act, which relates to, this section only relates to the responsibility of the credit bureaus to you as the consumer. So this is your right from the credit bureau to you as the consumer. And in there, I want to say it's section 6.8. On page 82, the ability of the consumer to dispute information directly with the furnishers. So section 16, part 660 of the law, it goes in to tell you exactly how you can dispute and what information they can and cannot furnish to the credit bureaus. And if you have it wrong twice on yours, one date showing one thing and the next date showing another thing, then that's completely wrong. So you can send a letter, which in the letters that we're going to send out. And if y'all would just respond back and let me know you got the letter on those, it'll be a Word document. That'll be perfect. And I'll scan this in and email this over to you in the statement of limitations data on there. I know some people got, well, they got something anyway. I won't say that you got that. On the laws, it does show itself exactly what they can and cannot do. So any two different dates that are showing as discrepancies, that's a quick challenge. So you can challenge it and have that removed right off. All right, guys, anything else? I don't know how we're going to do this. I'm telling you.